One of the questions I get asked most by you guys is how I think AI will impact the field of data analytics and whether or not AI will replace data analysts completely. So, to answer the AI-related questions once and for all, at least for now, let me quickly share my thoughts on this topic with you. Hey, my name is Mo Chen, and I work as a data and analytics analyst within the financial services industry. So, the big question, will generative AI replace data analysts? I'd say no, but it will certainly redefine the data analyst role. Since ChatGPT's release in November 2022, I've seen so many articles on how data analysts might be replaced by AI based mostly on the ability of these large language models, or LLMs, to write code. For example, ChatGPT recently released a plugin called Code Interpreter, which lets you upload data files and invoke Python to perform descriptive or regression analysis, and even create visualizations. And you can do all of this, obviously, without writing a single line of code. Would this be the end of the road for data analysts then? Probably not. I don't think so. As impressive as the capabilities of Code Interpreter or GitHub Copilot, or in general, LLMs like ChatGPT or Bard are, there are some significant limitations at the moment. The main one being security. I work at a big organization, and I would never get the approval to get any confidential data within my organization outside the company's firewall into a large language model that the firm has zero control over. So, the current, other, and probably most popular alternative is for each company to build their own large language model. Now, I'm not an AI expert, but training and fine-tuning such models, including the expertise and the personnel required around it, would incur massive costs, so would really only be a viable option for very few organizations. But say you work for a company that has its own large language model. If your job is solely made up of repetitive, business-as-usual tasks, such as creating financial reports by pulling in data using SQL queries, and then producing reporting in Excel using pivot tables and pivot charts, then yeah, generative AI will very likely replace you. But if you're a data analyst who has domain knowledge, someone who focuses on business outcomes, someone who identifies and solves business problems, then you should look at generative AI as your friend, not your enemy. Just think back to the turn of the millennium, the early 2000s, when a bunch of new business intelligence tools were introduced with one ultimate purpose: to allow non-technical people to leverage their domain knowledge by allowing them to analyze and present data without the need to write any code. I don't know about you, but this sounds suspiciously similar to the purpose of introducing generative AI to me. If you're not familiar with the roles and responsibilities of a data analyst, you might think that they just sit around writing some reusable code and produce reports and dashboards on a regular basis. But being a data analyst is much more than that. In my opinion, the greatest value of data analytics is the ability to answer ad hoc questions. Unforeseen, unpredicted, business-critical questions. Complex, multidimensional, non-linear questions. For example, why is the conversion rate for the new savings account lower than the other ones? Why did the customer churn rate triple last month? Why did the sales for the best-selling product decline suddenly? These are not straightforward questions that can be easily answered following some decision tree. To be able to answer these, you'll need domain knowledge. Say, for example, a small business owner running a coffee shop won't just magically create and develop an end-to-end data pipeline with automated and insightful visualizations and dashboards as one of the end products. Sure, ChatGPT or GitHub Copilot can help you write, optimize, and debug code. But if you don't actually know how to code, how do you even ask the right questions to prompt these AI tools? How would you even know what to look for? Now, of course, you could just fine-tune the company's model with more and more precise data, but it'd be very difficult to train the model on multi-dimensional questions that were never actually asked before. So, for these main reasons I just went through, and probably for numerous others, I don't see generative AI replacing data analysts completely. To me, the key lesson here is to take advantage of AI to help you become more effective and productive. Whether you're thinking about becoming a data analyst or you're already working as one, I strongly encourage you to learn how to use these new shiny AI tools like ChatGPT, GitHub Copilot, or Bard. Instead of being in constant AI fear, you could just make yourself AI-proof. At the end of the day, AI will not take your job, but people who will utilize these AI tools effectively, they will. I have no doubt that generative AI will reshape the field of data analytics. Change is constant and normal, and the question to me around AI is less so about will it replace data analysts, and more so about how can data analysts harness the power of AI to improve their workflows. In my opinion, a typical data analyst in the future is someone who can do the critical and analytical thinking to solve business critical problems, combined with the ability to leverage the power of generative AI tools to improve their data analysis workflows. So, that's all for now on AI and data analysis. If you like this video, make sure to check out some of my other videos right here. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.